Hello there, Taurus. Welcome into Sage Sensitive Healing. Tara, thank you so much for being here. I do hope you are well. May all your dreams be realized by you, which I feel is a high possibility here. Taurus, so welcome in general tarot card messages for the sign of Taurus. Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. On arrival, do hit the thumbs up button. You know, if the messages resonates with you and inspire you, hit the share button and share it to your groups, your blogs, etc. And if you have not yet subscribed, please do hit the subscribe button and become a part of this healing family journey here. Taurus, so for you, there's something about the home, or comfort, or a new beginning, or a transformation, or the ending of something. It is the end of something, and it's also the beginning of something, or maybe you're expecting that transformation, a change, a movement, okay? Some separation or a pull, okay? Maybe this has to do with love, Taurus, but maybe not. But it could be like you're going to meet someone that could possibly be your soulmate, or a love, or something divine. Or it could be passion bringing two people together or something like that. Like this, a similar heat or wavelength. Like putting two people together. Like, something like that. But there is an intention here. What is this? Let's ask. This magic. There's magic. Not just that, it's more like the spirit that brought you two together. Oh my God, the lovers. The spirit that will bring you two to meet is a spirit of something. You know, like it is a spirit of not anger, maybe emotions or courage. Or insight or bravery. It's the lion heart or a spirit of higher knowledge or bird's eye view with the eagle vibration as well. It's a spirit of charm and grace and eloquence. So this communion, this could be you and a community, or you know, Taurus, or you and someone else. It's like a blessing. Oh, maybe it's a vow, a commitment, a promise to, you know, and it involves feelings and love, and it could have something to do with a house in the distance, and maybe someone likes to wear, because I can feel this feminine's clothes around her ankles, so maybe that's important, the feeling of fabric. This fabric feels cottony and soft, comfortable. Maybe both of you are spiritual people, like, yeah. There's something calling for patience, like it took patience to achieve this, really. But I'm feeling that you're actually at the completion of this and looking back at the patience that it took for you to get here. And it's such a it's not delightful, but it's a pleasing, pleasure, nice, prideful feeling, proud, like, it's nice, you know, because I feel like it took strength, or it took something to hold it together, possibly, but not necessarily, but then you made it through. Maybe it took patience, like I was saying, patience, and I hear kindness and understanding. I don't know, pouring into cups, seeing things from a bird's eye view, like I say. Maybe it took the guidance of your angels, of your spirit guides, your third eye vision. It took a lot, not maybe a lot, but maybe it also, this time, it also helped you to develop your insights, your emotional sensitivity, your connection to earth or something, your spirits, your ancestors, maybe, you know what I mean? So you could be connecting to a fire sign, water sign, okay? There's something about work with the Eight of Pentacles too for you. Work. Taurus, there's so much good things I see. Like I say, I feel like your dreams will, that you're going to know that you're successful. Something about being feelings of well-being, the Queen of Pentacles. So, like, you will receive what you wanted. You will know what it feels like to have accomplished. You know, to be looked back in the past and know where you're coming from and to have. And this feels like money. This feels like a job. This feels like something that you've been working on or studying or feeling out. You know, it's like you weren't moving physically or to others, to us. In the physical, you weren't really doing anything, but at the same time, you were getting a taste for something. You were testing the waters and feeling it or something. And all of a sudden, I feel in the right time with the Sun card, you're going to come out. And it's a beautiful emergence for you. It's almost like you're rising up through the soul. Oh my God, that's beautiful. It's like, because you're getting a feel for it, like you're putting your foot in the water and feeling something. Could be something you're working on with the Eight of Pentacles, like writing, because the Pentacles energy is writing. Or whatever you're working on, building something, your own platform, your gifts. Because the Pentacles is what you, your gifts, your talents. And I hear investments too, something you're investing in makes you feel happy. And you're more hopeful than not, you know what I mean? And so as you give this taste, give your soul a taste of this thing that makes you feel good, because I feel like it's a part of your soul, this thing you're working on, that's when it emerges. I literally feel it moving up through the sole of your foot or feet, and it's like a spirit, like life when you shine. And it emerges. It's coming through your throat chakra, your heart, you know, but it's built in your soul and in your roots, your groundedness. So it's like this beautiful burst. This beautiful burst of light when you come out. Maybe you're going to be a guide or something. I do feel a lot of blessings with the fortune, Wheel of Fortune card. You're going to be celebrating. I feel like you could be a prophet. Yeah, you could be that. Like you have with the hangman vibration behind the sun. It feels like when you come out shining, because the hangman is psychic abilities, insight, intelligence. It's getting your information from within and not externally, you know? Like you're connected to a higher source. You know who you are. Alright, so I feel like, and you're kind of humble in spirit, Taurus. You've been using magic, or magic has been used. Now magic is, this magic feels beautiful. It feels like what is aligning you with your true gifts. It feels like just you working with the elements, being grateful. You know, looking for things around you to be thankful for, when you get the opportunity, you take an opportunity, stuff like that, like right on target, up to beat with your own life and what is unfolding in it. And importantly, enjoying the processes. And that's what leads you into the next big thing. So you could be coming across your soulmate sometime in this life as you know, on your journey here. Something to do with the home, Wheel of Fortune, celebration, laughter. All right. You know what I mean, Taurus? It's like you have achieved a vision that you have. You've been working on quietly for the longest time. You weren't speaking about this vision. That's why I'm saying, that's why the magician is here. Because you know what you're doing. It's like thinking I by the end of December I'm going to have a gold a bike or whatever, I don't know. But you're not talking about it, you're not bragging about it, just if someone is holding it in, I feel like that's you, that's how you manifest, you know what I mean? It's very powerful. You found maybe you are using the earth, a lot of the earth tendencies to manifest, to birth things into being. It feels like you're using your stubbornness, which is your ability to hold on to something until it presents itself. It's like your intention. That's the earth energy that you use so powerfully. And here I am. So teach. Okay, yeah, you use that to manifest. So it's like, yeah, as I was saying, someone knowing in themselves that they're going to have this, I'm going to have it. So when it actually arrives, it's not like a whole lot of surprise, but it's good. It feels good to know that you manifested this in the exact time that you said you wanted it, and you actually now possess it. So it's the energy of someone standing in that moment. This is, it feels like I'm reading your now energy or your future energy, Taurus, where you have this thing that you've visioned and you're standing in it, holding on to it, and you're in this moment, you're saying, whoa, I actually have this thing I dreamt of having. I now have it, and you know why. You know that you did this, but it's like you're keeping quiet about this magic, you know what I mean? It's not like you don't, maybe you don't consider it magic, but you know it's a gift that you have to, as if you found your gift, your true power to manifest like that with your, using your so-called stubbornness as a Taurus to manifest what you want. All I'm thinking is I could learn from you. You know, all that's all I'm thinking here. I could learn from you. Truthfully, thank you, Taurus, for being here. Hit the like button. Thank you. So yeah, in the beginning we said you're expecting a change, maybe with this Two of Cups, with a union, a vow that you made before. You're wondering about this. Yeah, this has to do with a home bumboclaat. Yo, this has to do with a home, a Queen of Cups, water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, in the home, like you're side eyeing this person. Your energy is, I'm not sure if it is anticipation or what is it? Impatience. Because seeing it below the Temperance card, the Nine of Wands, it's making me feel like you're impatient a bit, or watchful or suspicious of this union or collaboration that was made previously. I feel that you're like, so what's going on with that? I'm not laughing, but you're not alone. This Queen of Cups feels this vibration too, you know what I mean? Like this person is studying you. This could be your mother or a family member with the Cups vibration, relationship, people you love, care about. Cups energy, I like that it's the Queen of Cups. Tell me more about this Queen of Cups. Who is this? The Four of Cups. So it's definitely a relationship. This feels like someone who was keeping themselves to themselves, like not listening, not taking. The Four of Cups for me is, it's almost like twin flame energy too. Just this, but it's also someone taking time to sit in their own heart space. To heal or to figure out who they are and so on, to study, whatever. So I like the Four of Cups. Is someone using their discernment? And studying, feeling out things, connecting to roots, ancestry. So this Queen of Cups is studying something that has to do with justice or law or the balance. Equation with the High Priestess, amazing. The High Priestess. So definitely this is someone. What is this feeling? It's like studying the law and like figuring out maybe to make a decision or the High Priestess, intuition, insight, spiritual gifts, third eye vision, really the High Priestess, you know, that's who this person is. I don't know, it's like you're, what are you doing? Like you're suspicious of what is going on, you know, like look at your face, Taurus. I'm going to clarify your face. It's kind of funny, but not really. Let's take one more card for this High Priestess. Who is this High Priestess? Oh, what is the High Priestess and the Judgment? Oh, disseminating, disintegrating, departing, moving forward, chasing dreams. I don't know. Tell me about the Nine of Wands. I don't know. Someone is worried. Ten of Swords once more. Could be you, Taurus, worried. Old soulmate, past person, past love, returning, wanting to return. Nine of Pentacles, Swords, vibration pouring up inside out. Looking good, feeling good. Maybe someone wants to feel this way and you don't feel this way at this point. Maybe you wish someone would return or something. And then I see King of Pentacles and the King of the Castle or whatever. Someone wants to, I don't know, feel that way. And then we have the Three of Pentacles, something having to do with work or faces showing up at work or people disturbing you at work or something about this face. And the Three of Pentacles card that I can't never figure out what is this thing. It's like it's a joke. Oh, scared, intimidation, the King of Cups. To what? Somebody's maybe going to show up at work. Two people, possibly one person and a thing. And they're going to show you a thing, maybe. I don't know what this is going to be. Having to do with the change or moving on. Okay. I think at the end of the day, it's going to be beautiful, success, abundance, material success and happiness, feelings of greatness, the emergence of you. Remember, we spoke about that earlier. You're going to come out, you're going to be successful, you're going to have what you want. You know what I mean? You're going to realize that, oh, I've been hoping for this and it is finally here. But it's almost like it happened so quick. It happened before, you know, like you're saying, all of a sudden, I have this thing that I've been anxiously waiting for. And today, I'm looking at myself and I'm like, oh, I have it. It's the energy of someone wanting to move into a different apartment and thinking, when is this ever going to happen? And then one day, they're living in the apartment and remembering the days when they used to dream of moving on or moving forward or having this thing, you know? And it happens so quickly. So the Sun card is telling me it's all going to work out for you and for everyone else involved beautifully. Important, we're looking at patience with the Temperance energy. Sagittarius vibration. The strength. Talking about strength. Talking about releasing, even releasing past sadness. The strength to do so. The Sun energy. Ability to burn through certain energies. Sadness, childhood things, memories, families, emotions. Things that hurt you that still effing linger. The fuck, I can see that. Mm-hmm. It's causing you to maybe think away or make certain decisions. Things that you lost, people you loved. All right, dear Taurus, the Bull. Much love to you on your journey. Remember, all that you want is on its way to you. Sooner than you think, I feel. Before you know it. It's like before you know it. That's the vibration. It's happened. All right. Thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing to the channel. I will see you in the next one. These messages have been quite interesting and beautiful. And look at that, we have the Sun card once more, like doubly. I love this. It says divine, full expression, vibrant expression, graced, forgiveness. You have my attention, truth and light. Okay.